Margaret Mead has worked as an anthropologist with peoples of different cultures in the South Pacific. As a result, she has had the opportunity of bringing new insights to Western women and men concerned with their functional roles in this society.
We may well find that there are certain fields, such as physical sciences, mathematics, and instrumental music, in which men, by virtue of their sex, as well as by virtue of their qualities as specially gifted human beings, will always have that razor edge of extra gift which makes all the difference, and that while women may easily follow where men lead, men will always make the new discoveries. We may equally well find that women, through the learning involved in maternity, which once experienced can be taught more easily to all women, even childless women, than to men, have a special superiority in those human sciences which involve that type of understanding which is called intuition. If intuition is based upon an ability to recognize difference from the self rather than upon one to project the self in building a construct or a hypothesis, it may well be that the greatest gifts will be found among women. We shall be ready to synthesize both kinds of gifts in the sciences, which are now sadly lopsided, with their far greater knowledge of how to destroy than of how to construct, far better equipped to analyze the world of matter into which man can project his intelligence than the world of human relations, which requires the socialized use of intuition. The mother who must learn that the infant who was but an hour ago a part of her body is now a different individual with its own hungers and its own needs, and that if she listens to her own body to interpret the child will die, is schooled in an irreplaceable school. As she learns to attend to that different individual, she develops a special way of thinking and feeling about human beings. We can leave these special learnings at the present level, or convert them into a more elaborate part of our civilization. We can build a whole society only by using both sexes, by using the gifts of the whole of humanity.
In her studies of different cultural attitudes learned from peoples in the South Pacific, Dr. Mead said,
"We may contrast mothers in different societies with different emphasis. The Arapesh treat a baby as a soft, vulnerable, precious little object, to be protected, fed, cherished. Not only the mother, but the father also must play this overall protective role. Whenever it is willing to eat, even if it does not show any signs of hunger, it is fed, gently, interestedly. The Arapesh form of child rearing stresses complementariness in a form that is most easily transformed by women into an adult feminine role. It is a society that makes it much more difficult to be a male, especially in all those assertive, creative, productive aspects of life on which the superstructure of a civilization depends. Where the upbringing fits most women, it fits only a few men. We find among the Iatmul headhunters that from birth the baby is handled as if it were a separate little entity capable of a will of its own. As soon as the Iatmul child is a few weeks old, the mother no longer carries it everywhere with her or sits with it on her lap, but instead places it at some distance on a high bench where it must cry lustily before it is fed. The child learns that anger and self-assertion will be rewarded. Children of each sex form images that will later inform their feeling about copulation. The girl child forming a more active picture of her own role, the boy child, a more active picture of the female's role.